This video, I'm going to show you how to get started with Filament PHP. So first and foremost, we just want to go ahead and create a new Filament PHP project. So we're just going to use Laravel installer here, which you can easily compose or require if needed. And I'm just going to call this Filament starter tutorial. And for this, let's just use Jetstream, which will work perfectly fine with Livewire. And let's just enable dark mode and pest as well. So with that sorted now, we're basically just installing it using the Laravel installer. So let's head into our project now and take a look at how we can get started with Filament PHP. And for the database as well, we want to use PostgreSQL, although you could use SQLite if you want to. So I'm going to go ahead into the project now while this is installing. So I've just gone ahead and configured the database configuration. So what I'm going to go ahead and do now is I want to go ahead and migrate this. And this should all be fine now in the database. So with that sorted, let's go ahead to a browser in here as well. And you can just check that it works. That's fine. So let's go ahead to a browser in here and let's go to Filament PHP. And in here, I want to just go to get started section, and we just need to copy these two commands here. So let's go ahead and run these two. So what this will go ahead and do is it will install the 3.2 version of Filament PHP. Later on, you'll see that it also actually adds a few folders in here. So let's go ahead and take a look at those as well. The admin panel ID is basically just what the URL you want to be when you access the site. So for example, we want this to be /admin, but you could have this to be anything you want. So I'm just going to go ahead and call this the default name /admin. And I would highly recommend going ahead and starting this on GitHub as well. So with that sorted, let's take a look at what just happened here. So installing Jetstream has created this folder here where we have the Jetstream folder, which is fine. That's to be expected. And then we have a Filament provider in here. Now, this is where you can configure your application. You can add plugins. You can configure the middleware and so on. You will also be able to add in different pages here, although that will auto load by default. You can change the primary color. So for example, if you wanted this to be green instead, then what would happen is when we log into the admin panel, it would look green. But let's be before we get started with that, let's go ahead and create a Filament super user, which will be basically just this command here. So me just making a mistake, it's not called Filament super user, it's just called Filament user. And I'm just gonna get some details in here and let's go ahead and create this. Just gonna add in a password. And now if we go to this Filament starter tutorial, we should just be able to go to /admin. And as you can see, I could go ahead and change this to cyan, for example, if I wanted to have it be a cyan color. I can just go ahead and log in. And there we go. So for now, this is basically how it looks like. You can switch between dark and light mode. So the best way to show off Filament PHP, I think for this example, is just to create a quick user panel here, a user resource. So we want to make a Filament resource and we want to call this user resource. So this will go ahead inside here and append Filament folder, which will contain the resources folder. And in here, we now have all this here. So if you go ahead and refresh the page, you can clearly see that this has been auto-loaded. So basically, we are discovering pages within the Filament pages here. So that should by default work for us because we create the resources, should by default load this in. However, where you might find this useful is if you have to register a custom page from a plugin, for example, or if you want to have some more advanced pages, which we will look at a later tutorial. So with that sorted, another thing I always like to do when I have a filament is enabling the spar feature, which will allow us to have a single page application vibe with appending via navigate into all the links. So basically, if we go ahead now in here, we should just be able to inspect element. And in here, you can see we have via navigate appended now. Whereas beforehand, if we remove this, it's removed. So basically, that's another neat feature I always like to add in. So before we end this off, I'm not going to go ahead and show how to create a user or anything like that. I'm just going to go ahead and show you how to add a column here. So text column. And in this case, let me this the name. So if you just go ahead and refresh, remove the inspector element, and there you go. Now I can see the user here. We could add in edit functionality. You could also do the same thing for the email if you fancy, for example. And there you go. So that's all for this video. This video is really just to get you very briefly started with Filament PHP and how to set it up and how it works from a very basic level. This is, I think, the quickest way you can get started. You can change the icon in here as well. And outside of that, you'll also be able to add in different relationships, for example, or filters if you want to. You'll be able to, in this form schema here, you'll be able to, for example, go ahead and update something by adding in a text input, or for example, create a new use if that's what you want. So this is a super convenient way that you can easily create an admin panel using Filament PHP. So that's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching it, and I'll see you in the next one.